Hello, I'm Tomasz Konieczny and I work at XSolve as Senior Quality Assurance Engineer. A few weeks ago I talked with XSolve CEO Piotr about security of Internet of Things devices. We're especially curious if this famous quote, the S in IoT stands for security, would be correct in the case of IoT cars. And because Piotr is the owner of Tesla Model X, we decided to check it. He gave me his keys, or more precisely, his password to the Tesla car. Yes, as you can expect from IoT device, there has to be a mobile app for it. Okay, so let's see what this app can actually do. This app is more than just a key. It's more like remote control center for users. You may check correlated info such as charging or battery level. You may also check the car's location. You may also control the car. You can flash the lights, honk the horn, or start the engine. In case of application that allows controlling vehicle worth tens of thousands of dollars, I would expect that security would be the priority. In case of Tesla's app, I would rather say it's insecure by design. Single password is currently considered as insufficient because it's a single point of failure. Because of that, multi-factor authentication is used almost everywhere. For example, if you use your bank account, you have to confirm some actions with the second factor, like SMS code or a token. In the case of Tesla's app, two-factor authentication is not available in any form, even as an option. Whole security of the application depends on just one password. I would expect that if 2FA is not available, the app will offer at least some verification of new devices. Not in this case. If you know the password, you can log in and the owner won't be even aware of it. So maybe detection of non-standard user activity. During our tests, we logged in on multiple different devices, even hundreds of kilometers away from the car. From our owner's perspective, we haven't triggered any actions, so we can assume that it's not implemented or at least it's not working as expected. The notification system is available on the Tesla app, but it's designed mostly for standard actions like charging. Taking into account the flaws mentioned earlier, it should be definitely extended with notifications related to the security. The problem with notifications is not just about the Tesla app. You won't even receive notification about the password change. Existence of users' community is a great thing, especially if they are active and creative. It's a huge benefit for users if they can use third-party apps that provide functionalities not available in the official one. Tesla doesn't officially provide API, but has been documented by the community and it's widely used in practice. However, there is a serious problem in case of Tesla. It's not possible to authenticate in the secure way, so the applications use the only available method, password for Tesla account. Considering this password is a single point of failure, it's a huge risk for the users. It's not only the risk of the password loss, but it's also against the basic security practices. Instead of using the lowest possible permissions, the users hand over full access to the car. Security conscious users aren't likely to share the login credentials with the third-party app. However, the less aware may do so. Tesla holds no responsibility for the third-party apps, however, they can make an impact on how the ecosystem looks. How? One of the options is to allow users to generate API keys. With combination with permissions control, it would allow them to give the applications just the specific permissions. The other, probably more convenient method would be to use widely used standard for authentication or auth. Security isn't just a technical matter. Even the correct implementation won't be secure if there's a flaw in security design. In this app, obtaining just one password could not only cause significant money loss, but could also be a substantial threat for users' privacy.